There are times when the data isn't available and you need to collect your own. Now, when talking about the various methods that can be used, there are a few factors that distinguish them. For instance, there's the level of intervention. Is it observational, which is strictly hands-off, or is it experimental, where you get in the mix and you create a situation? What kind of data type do you have? Is it quantitative or numerical data, which is what we often use in data science? Or is it qualitative, specifically text, which can be analyzed but requires different approaches? And how about the location? Is it online or is it in person? All of these combinations can be used to gather data that you need if you're careful about your design. For instance, let's look at interviews. These are ideal for new topics or audiences. They can be structured or unstructured. However, interviews are generally very time-consuming, and they may require a very specialized training. This is one of the situations where you actually may want to hire an anthropologist or a sociologist to come in and conduct the research for you. Next, surveys. They can be open-ended or closed-ended. They're very easy to administer online to a lot of people. But you need to watch out for wording and sampling bias in order to get the information that's going to be really most useful in helping you reach your goals in your project. Next is card sorting. This is where participants sort topics that are written on different cards. Card sorting is useful for determining categories and hierarchies. It's also a great way to check the usability of a website. You can actually do different kinds of card sorting in terms of an exploratory one to find out how you should do it, and another kind to see how well your proposed solution works. Next, how about experiments? This is where you have a manipulation. That's where you get involved, and you cause a situation to be different for one group of people or another. Some people freak out about the word manipulation and think it's about coercion or mind control. It simply means about creating different conditions. And it is generally considered the best method for cause and effect inferences. On the other hand, in most situations, experimentation can be labor-intensive and can require very extensive specialized training. There is one major exception to this, and that's A/B testing, which is used on web pages where you have two versions of a web page or an element on a web page, and it's randomly assigned, one version or another, to viewers. In summary, to start a data science project, you'll first get exactly the data that you need. If what it doesn't exist, you will have to collect the new data. Many of these methods may require in-depth training, and you may want to hire consultants for them. Also, there are important ethical issues when conducting research, especially when it's live and in person. You'll want to consult an expert about those.